You're a Love Burger, Love Burger?
Yeah.
It's vegetarian, isn't it?
It's vegan. Is it speaking to you?
It's not speaking to me in a language I understand, but it is talking to me.
Okay, so there's communication.
Yes.
Which is the basis of love. Love on top of love, basically. I'm putting words in your mouth, I don't want to go there. So...
That's
a good thing. That's... It's not a bad thing.
Have a Love Burger, please.
Love Burger?
One group of love, the Love Burger family. What do people love? The Love Burger. I'd like to know about your feelings for the Love Burger.
They're generally fairly affectionate feelings. Yeah.
You're a lover of the Love Burger.
I am indeed.
Why do you love the Love Burger?
Because it has all the flavour.
The dressing is delicious.
It doesn't sort of stimp on any extras.
How tall are you?
6'3".
It doesn't fall apart, it's not dry.
My dad was 6'3", I can tell. I feel like you're going to tell me off. Would you say that it's a long-term relationship that you feel?
Yeah, we're certainly not in any plans to break off anytime soon. Okay.
Have a nice bread.
I've taken a bus all the way to King's Cross to go and get one from Kentish Town.
Are you faithful?
I am also partial to occasionally having a bit of the grilled chicken burger.
We just wanted to know how much you loved the Love Burger, and I think you love it. Okay, that's fine. I don't want to push you any more on that. She clearly loves it, okay? You love it?
No, I love it. It's
okay, let's leave it there then.
So clearly, people love the Love Burger, but they're not all vegans that are eating it.
Okay. I'm not a vegan or a vegetarian. But
100% plant-based?
No, I'm not plant-based.
Okay, you're not vegan, but you kind of want to be more plant-based, I imagine.
Yeah.
So I can reduce my impact on the planet.
So they're eating it because it's plant-based, and it's delicious. I think to understand why people love the Love Burger, we need to understand where it comes from.
Remember Genghis Khan and the Mongols? They were the original big fans of the burger. Ooh, that's a great name for a pop band.
Anyway, they found that flattened ground meat was easier to carry around on horseback while they were going around conquering and killing people.
Who'd have thought? Eventually, this style of meat found its way to Hamburg in Germany.
And in turn, found its way to New York via some Hamburg sailors around 1890.
Right, let's fast forward a little bit.
Edward Gold, in 1934, launches the Wimpy Burger brand in Bloomington, Indiana. And here's the first Wimpy in the UK at Lion's Corner House in London in 1954. Problem was, I'm not sure us Brits knew what a burger was back then.
What is it, Gavner?
Well, clearly, it's obviously some kind of pie. Go away, peasant.
Richard and Morris McDonald's opened their first restaurant in San Bernardino, California in 1940. And in 1953, Ray Kroc, he's the guy Michael Keaton played in the film The Founder, he bought the company for a sweet $2.7 million. Yeah, it turned over $21 billion last year. Awkward. In the same year, Keith J. Kramer and family opened Insta Burger King. Yeah, it's not good, is it? Well, in 1954, the company was sold and renamed to Burger King. Much better. I mean, like, how could Insta be used as a name for some sort of business? It would seem that everyone loves a burger, even veggies and vegans. The world famous leading vegan burger was created back in 2009 by LA-based meat substitute business Beyond Meat. And Professor Mark Post loves a burger that much that he grew one in his laboratory in 2013.
So I'm off to find out what's the secret behind the Love Burger. Come on.
Was it love at first sight? Well, it wasn't, no. We had to go on a few dates, didn't we?
Yeah.
And dump a few burgers before we fell in love with the Love Burger. I guess what we wanted to do was to make a blockbuster beef burger without, which was vegan. And we wanted something that felt a bit more indulgent and like you were maybe having something that tastes a bit like meat.
Yeah. Tried mushrooms and tofu, and then there was sunflower seeds added.
As food developers, what were the things that pissed you off?
Really, I think for me it's kind of texture and taste. Patty that's too bland, that it doesn't really stand up to the rest of the ingredients.
Any one of those particular flavours overbearing.
So you want something that tastes good,
yes,
looks good, and is still quite good for you.
So with some dried soy, there we go.
then.
So there's our mincemeat, soy mince. Yep.
So we need to add some flavour. A blend of herbs and spices, which we can't tell you because it's a secret. Beetroot powder, flavour and colour. Some pepper and some oil.
We're going to make some burger patties.
Now we're
going to
pop them in the oven.
Okay, now we're going to start on the topping. Off now with some cheese and some burger sauce. And that's the Love Burger done.
Lovely.
Did you do one for me?
Fat chance.
Nah.
So now you know the love that goes into the Love Burger.
Love Burger, man.
Another Love Burger.